In this video, we will discuss the definition of a day and a year as part of the general navigation subject for ESA ATPL, and we are starting right now. The focus of this channel is to provide explanations for ESA ATPL examination and other aviation related stuff. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to Answering ATPL by clicking the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. There are three definitions of a day that we need to understand for general navigation. They are sidereal days, apparent solar days, and mean solar days. Before we discuss the definition, let's first examine the requirements for the length of a day so it will be useful to us. We call the description that fit all the requirements as civil days. As a human being, our activity is governed by the position of the sun in the sky. Noon or 12 p.m. is ideal when the sun is halfway between sunrise and sunset. Because of this, the first requirement of civil day is it shall be based on the movement of the sun across the sky. The second requirement is civil day shall be of constant length. This is because to keep accurate time using mechanical or digital equipment, the length of the day needs to be constant. According to many cultures, a day is the amount of time taken from midday to the next midday, or midnight to the following midnight, or sunrise to the next sunrise, or sunset to the next sunset. This cultural definition can be translated as a day is the amount of time taken for the Earth to complete one revolution on its axis. If we draw a line from the center of the Earth to the center of the Sun, passing a meridian, in this case marked with the red line, we call this meridian transit. The Earth rotates once until we have the second transit of the same meridian. The time taken between two successive meridian transit is one day. The diagram on the screen shows the Earth in its orbit around the Sun at perihelion. The meridian represented as the red line is at meridian transit or aligned with the center of the Sun. At the same time, a distant star also aligned with the red line. If we use the distant star as a reference point to measure Earth's 360-degree rotation about its own axis, the situation will look similar to the animation on the screen. The time taken from the initial position to the current position is known as a sidereal day. A sidereal day is the time it takes for the Earth to complete one rotation about its own axis with respect to a distant star. As you might notice, the red meridian is not aligned with the center of the Sun. To complete one day in relation to the Sun, the Earth need to travel further on its orbit. The time taken from the initial position to the current position is known as an apparent solar day. An apparent solar day is the time it takes for the Earth to complete one rotation about its own axis with respect to the Sun. The term apparent means that is the way it appears to us. It is the actual situation. Now let's take a look at the properties of sidereal day. Sidereal day is of a constant length. It takes the Earth 23 hours and 56 minutes to turn 360 degrees with respect to a distant star. However, sidereal day does not relate to the movement of the Sun across the sky. Furthermore, it does not refer to the hour of daylight. At perihelion, the meridian marked in red is at 12 noon. If we use sidereal day as the basis of our time system, 6 months later, the same meridian will give 12 noon on the clock, but it is actually at midnight. If we compare sidereal day to civil day requirement, the sidereal day does not meet the first requirement and cannot be used as civil day. Now, let's look at the properties of apparent solar day. To explain the length of apparent solar day, we need to recall Kepler's second law. Kepler's second law states, the radius vector from the sun to a planet sweep out equal areas in equal time. One of the effects associated with this law is the difference in orbital speed. The orbital speed at perihelion is higher compared to the orbital speed at aphelion. Because of this, the time taken for two successive meridian transit is longer at perihelion compared to at aphelion. At perihelion, the length of an apparent solar day is 24.25 hours, whereas at aphelion, the length of an apparent solar day is 23.75 hours. If we compare apparent solar day to civil day requirement, apparent solar day does not meet the second requirement and cannot be used as civil day. Both sidereal day and apparent solar day does not meet civil day requirements. To have a time system that is useful for us, we average out the fluctuation of apparent solar day between 24.25 hours and 23.75 hours, which give us 24 hours. Because this calculation is based on apparent solar day, we now satisfied both requirement of civil day. We now have mean solar day. Mean solar day is the basis of local mean time, which we will discuss in length on the next video. Mean solar day assume that the mean sun, which sometimes referred to as fictitious sun, move along the equator at a constant speed of 15 degrees per hour at all time. Because we average out the apparent solar day to get the mean solar day, as a result, 12 noon on our clock is not the exact moment of meridian transit. The difference can be as much as a quarter of an hour. The difference is known as the equation of time. On the screen is the graph that depicted how the equation of time changes over the year. The vertical axis is local mean time at a particular meridian, and the horizontal axis represent the date. The red curve indicates time of meridian transit. As you can see, there are only 4 days a year when the meridian transit happens at 12 noon. The maximum difference occurs in November and February. In November, the meridian transit will happen at 11:44 local mean time, and in February, the meridian transit will happen at 12:14 local mean time. Now, we will define the length of a year. Even though there are two methods to define the length of a year, sidereal and tropical, I will only explain on the tropical year. This is because both type of year have approximately the same length, and sidereal year is not being emphasized in the syllabus. A solar year is the amount of time the Earth takes to complete an orbit in relation to the Sun. Earth completes an orbit around the Sun in 365 days, 5 hours, 48 minutes and 45 seconds, or approximately 365.25 days. This is the reason why our calendar year is 365 days and during leap years 366 days. The leap year happens every 4 years. The reason why we added Leap year is to prevent calendar runaway due to additional quarter day every year. If we do not add the leap year every 4 years, the additional quarter day every year will compound over time. After a significant amount of time, our date and season will not correspond to each other. We might have winter in July and summer in January. That is why we have a leap year every 4 years. In actual, the determination of leap year is much more complicated than every 4 years. However, to pass general navigation subject, the fact stated here is enough. What do you think of this video? Please let me know in the comment section below. And if you find the video beneficial, please like it and share with others. By doing so, you will help other people to find the video. If you want to learn more about ATPL or other aviation related stuff, subscribe now by clicking the round subscribe icon. Please check out my other video by clicking on the rectangular box. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.